everyone, it's Gordy.
And I'm Alexis.
And you're watching
The Weekend Experience. Welcome back, friends. We are so excited that you're here this weekend. Right, Gordy?
I am so excited.
Wow, you seem way too excited. Do you have like fun plans this weekend or something?
Alexis, let me tell you, I have so many fun things planned.
I don't remember getting any invites, so.
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm going to the park with my friends. We're gonna have a huge baseball tournament. There's gonna be competition. There's gonna be snow cones. There's gonna be orange slices. It's gonna be pretty amazing.
That sounds amazing. I wish someone would have invited me.
Yeah, anyway, I'm super bummed because there's a chance it might rain, and if it rains, then we can't do it.
Yeah, that would really stink. Well, you know, you could pray about it.
Well, why would I do that?
Because God controls everything, including the weather.
Well, I guess I never thought about it that way. That's a really good idea.
Thank you. So, do you think I'd get invited now?
Well, yeah, I guess I could. I could invite you. I don't know why. I never thought about that. Do you even know how to play baseball?
Of course I know how to play baseball. It's all about just scoring goals and not getting tackled, right?
Not exactly.
Anyways, speaking of games, I have a really fun game for us today. You want to play?
Sure.
All right, guys, it's time to play a game that I like to call Close Up. All right, guys, the way this game works is I'm gonna show you guys and Gordy a picture of something super close up, super zoomed in, and you have to try and guess what the actual picture is. It's gonna be kind of hard because it's gonna be just a small part of the picture and really close, but I think you guys can do it. Are you ready to play?
I'm so ready.
All right, let's see how many Gordy can get. Let's see how many you guys can get. Here we go, first picture. What do you think this is, Gordy?
Maybe cheese?
Maybe cheese. It has lots of...
Could be dried up cheese.
Dried up cheese, okay. Is that your final answer?
Maybe some form of rocks, maybe in the desert.
Okay.
I'm going with dried up cheese, though.
All right.
Probably dried up cheese.
This picture is not dried up cheese. It is a picture of a walnut.
Wow. Close. Close. Maybe.
Super close. All right, next picture. You guys ready? Here we go. All right, what do you think that
is? Oh my goodness.
It's orange and black.
Wow, it kind of looks like one of those inflatables that you go to a birthday party and you see a big giant inflatable.
Okay.
Or some form of Halloween costume, could be.
Yeah, orange and black, I see you.
Yep, I don't know, what is it?
What's gonna be your final guess, what do you think?
Inflatable.
Inflatable,
yep.
Well, Gordy, it is a picture of a car.
Wow.
It is a VW
Bug. And we're
taking
a drive-through Proverbs. I should have known that.
I know.
I should have known.
Okay. All right, next picture is, what is that?
Ooh.
Wow.
Oh.
There's lots of texture in there.
This looks like from the
beautiful
ocean.
Beautiful colors.
Like,
okay.
An anemone, however you
a
say that.
Sea anemone.
Yep, those
sea
things.
Anemone.
Yep, and the water.
Okay,
And the waves. Yep, that's what I'm going with.
That's what you're going
coral
with.
Coral reef, maybe.
Okay, well, this actually is strawberry ice cream.
Oh my goodness.
Not even close,
wow.
But that's okay. You're doing great.
Can we
you're doing
strawberry
great.
Strawberry ice cream, though?
I know, that
sounds
does
really
sound
good.
Really good. All right, Gordy, what do you think this is?
Wow. That
very nice.
Looks like.
What do you guys
you
think?
You know the accordion? You know, I'm an expert accordion player.
Harmonica?
Looks like zoomed in. Yep, harmonica.
Harmonica.
That's what I said.
Yep. Okay.
Expert, as I said.
Okay.
It kind of looks like really zoomed in.
Okay.
Or it could be a mattress, really zoomed in on a
bed
mattress.
That is a good
but
guess.
I am going to go with a harmonica.
Okay, what are you guys thinking? Are harmonica mattress kind of the vibe you were going for? Because this picture is actually a Converse shoe. See, it's the edge of the shoe. I know. It's really hard. Okay. Are you guys ready for another one? Here we go.
Absolutely.
Okay. What? Ooh, this one is tricky.
Whoa.
This one's tricky. I thought it was going to be easy, but it actually kind of looks really hard. What do you think?
This looks like...
Very dimensional. It has lots of layers to
interesting.
It.
Interesting.
What do you guys think?
Very interesting. Maybe a Lego brick or...
Okay.
Kind of looks like ridges on weights in a gym, maybe.
Ooh.
But
guess.
I'm a huge fan of Legos, okay. So I'm gonna go with Legos.
All right, what do you guys think? Is Legos a good guess or a bad guess? This correct picture is a camera. It is the lens of a camera or the viewfinder of the camera.
I should've known.
I know. All right, guys, we're gonna do two more. Here we go. Gordy has not gotten any so far. Okay, what do you think? This one's kind of easy.
That looks like either the edge of an iPhone with a case on or an airplane window.
What's gonna be your final guess? One of those is right.
Oh man, the pressure. I am gonna go with airplane window.
It's actually the side of an iPhone.
Oh man.
You were close, you actually got one right. All right, guys.
I can't get it right.
Last one, here we go. Okay, let's see what it is.
Ooh. That looks like some sort of dessert, maybe.
Looks
like some honey might be dripping off of it. Or like a cinnamon roll pastry type thing.
Can
I just go with like a pastry in general?
Okay. Well, it is a stack of French toast. So
I'll
give it to you.
That could be pastry.
I will give it to you.
I think it should count.
All right, guys, Gordy got 1 point.
Woo!
How many did you guys get? All right, hope you guys had fun playing the game today.
All right, wow, that game was awesome.
I know, I love games. But you know what else I love?
Tacos.
Worship.
Oh yeah, that, of course, worship. All right, everybody ready? Let's stand to our feet and let's worship.
I read your word. Open up my heart. I want to worship you. When I get quiet and I read. My Father, you're my best friend, and you love me, you hear me, that will never end. Hey! I'll seek you, I'll find you, I'll give you my praise, and I will follow you. You're my maker, my Father, you're my best friend, and you love me, you hear me, that will never end. I'll seek you, I'll find you, I'll give you my praise, and I will follow you. All of my days, all my days, all my days. is alive. The empty cross, the empty grave. Life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive.
So Taylor's teaching last week was so awesome. I learned so much stuff.
Me too. We learned how Solomon prayed to God and asked him for wisdom. Alexis, guess what I did this last week?
Oh no. What did you do, Gordy?
I prayed to God and asked him for wisdom.
Oh, that's actually awesome. And guess what, Gordy?
What?
I did the same thing.
Wow, that is amazing. So now that we've prayed to God and asked him for wisdom, now what do we do?
Well, maybe we should take it to the Bible breakdown with Taylor and see what he has to say this week.
I think that's a great idea. What are we waiting for? Let's do it.
I still remember the time when I was in elementary school. You see, our parents just bought one of those single-story plastic homes that like you put in your backyard and you go in and you play house in. I remember my parents bought that for my sister, and I never really liked playing house, but what I liked to do was climb up on the roof and jump off into the grass in our backyard because I thought that was a lot more fun. But the person that did not like me doing that was my dad because he knew eventually I would get hurt. However, I thought he was just out there trying to steal my fun, so I remember one time specifically when he was at work, so I went on the roof, I jumped off, and I landed like this, like right on my wrist, on the grass. It hurt super bad, I was crying, it was the very first broken bone that I had ever had, I had to get a cast, like it was bad. And it all came out of the fact that I disobeyed my dad. You see, when my dad told me not to jump off of the roof, I thought he was just trying to steal my fun. But the reality is that he was wiser than me, and he knew that I would get hurt. You see, when it comes to our faith, I think that story is a great example of how we approach things with God. You see, oftentimes God tells us not to do certain things, or he tells us to do certain things, but we might look at those things as God just trying to steal our fun away from life. Or maybe we just take it as a guy that is giving us advice, but we don't really have to listen to that advice if we don't want to, kind of like a take it or leave it type of thing. But you see, the reality is God. Like, that means he's all powerful, he's all knowing, he's all wise, and he always knows the best thing to do. Last week, we started this series in Proverbs, and there's another proverb that I want to read to you. It's right here in Proverbs 1:7. It says, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction." You see, if you want to be a wise person, which I hope you do, last week we talked about how important it is to be wise. If you want to be a wise person, can I challenge you with something? Start with God. And that's so easy for me to say, but it's harder to actually do. Because whenever I come across a situation, I always think, what do I want to do? What do I feel is best? But I've realized that whenever I lean on the things that I think is best, that's normally when poor consequences happen, like me breaking my wrist. You see, if you want to be wise, start with God. And then we have to have the faith and the trust that whatever he tells us to do is always the best thing. There's one other proverb I want to read to you. It's in Proverbs 3, verses 5 through 6. It says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek his will in all you do, and he will show you which path to take." Is there a situation in your life where you've been depending on your own knowledge and on what you think is best? Let me challenge you. Go to God first. Really, what that practically means is either through prayer or to the Bible, and see what God has to say, and then have the faith to do what he's asking you to do. Let's pray. God, thank you that you have given us the Bible that is full of wisdom. I pray that we can be people that go to you first. God, help us believe that you are the wisest, that you always know how to handle any situation. It's in your name we pray, amen.
All right, you guys, it is challenge time. I hope you did our challenge last week, which was memorizing our Bible verse, Proverbs 3, 5 through 6, and praying and asking God for wisdom. I hope you guys did that last week, and today I have a new challenge for you. And that is to ask yourself, who is God of your life? Is it God or is it you? Who are you allowing to make the decisions, and who are you trusting with your life? Because like we talked about today, wisdom, the start of wisdom is trusting that God knows what's best for us and trusting that he is God and we are not. And just like our game today, we were looking at a very small picture of something that was attached to a greater picture. And all we could see was that super small zoomed in piece. And sometimes that's what it's like when we look at our life. We just see our here and now and what's right in front of us. But you guys, God sees the entire picture, and he knows everything about us, everything about our life, and he knows how to guide us. And so we have to trust that God sees everything, and we can only see this small piece. So who are we to be God of our life when we can only see that little bit and God sees it all? So I want you guys to ask yourself this week, who is God of your life? And maybe you're watching this and you're like, hey, I don't have a God of my life, and I've never accepted Christ into my life. Then if that's you, that is where you have to start. Maybe find an adult in your life who loves Jesus and go and ask them, how do I have a relationship with God and allow him to be the one that makes the decisions for my life? Because God is God and we are not. Okay, wow. So we can't just pray for wisdom one time and just be done.
Right? I think it's so easy to forget that God is still in control. Even when life doesn't make sense, all we have to do is ask and he'll give us wisdom.
Yeah, and we have to know that through the whole process, he loves us so much.
Right? I love that.
Me too. And you know, Gordy, this makes me think of our memory verse for this month, which says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him and he will make your path straight." Proverbs 3, 5 through 6.
That is such a great reminder, Alexis. It's just for us to remember that God is God and we're not. And even when life doesn't make sense, His plan is still greater than ours.
Yeah, and just like that verse talks about, where God will make our path straight, we really need His help to do that through the entire process. And this whole series of Proverbs, we're gonna be talking about practical ways to live more like Jesus. And I know that I'm gonna need His help through a lot of these.
I know I sure am, but it makes me excited for what we're gonna learn about the next couple weekends.
Me too.
I can't wait. That's all we have for you guys. We can't wait to see you next weekend.
Bye.